Hi, let's talk about the ascending aorta and the coronary arteries. So as I've discussed, there are certain landmarks that I look to in trying to figure out exactly what I'm looking at when I see an angle of the heart. So let me share with you some of what I see here. So this is the ascending aorta, and it's going into the arch of the aorta. This is the pulmonary trunk. My first giveaway that this is the ascending aorta and not the pulmonary trunk is that I can see the coronary arteries originating from it. The coronary arteries are going to come from the ascending aorta. They are the only branches of the ascending aorta, so look for them. In terms of branching patterns, this one here is the LCA, I can see a very distinct anterior interventricular artery and then a circumflex branch going that way. Over here, I can see the RCA originating and going down, and I can see some veins kind of jumping over it or bridging over it. So those are going to be anterior cardiac veins. So if this is the anterior interventricular artery coming down that way, here's the anterior interventricular sulcus. Here's the auricle of the right atrium. Here's the coronary sulcus going down. So this is more of an anterosuperior view of the heart. If we look to the left here, this is almost a superior view of the heart with the atria removed. And so let's go back to our good friend, our dear friend, the ascending aorta. We can see there are two vessels originating from it, so that makes that the pulmonary trunk. And we can see how the right coronary artery is going to come down and wrap around throughout the coronary sulcus. And then here's the left. It's kind of going that way and then down around that way. And so we're going to have our tricuspid valve there and our bicuspid valve there. And let's really get into the granular details of these branches. So the origins of the coronary arteries are the aortic sinuses. The aortic sinuses are the most inferior part of the root of the aorta, and they are the spaces above the right and left and posterior or non-coronary cusps of the aortic valve. These sinuses fill up with blood during diastole. Therefore, the coronary arteries fill with blood during diastole. Here is the pulmonary trunk. Here is the right auricle. There is the superior vena cava opening. Here's the base of the heart. And we can see that it's been incised there. And so there's the left atrium. And here's the auricle of the left atrium. The right atrium is going to be over here. So we really have a sense for which way is up, so to speak. Let's start our study with the left coronary artery, or the LCA. That left coronary artery has two branches. Sometimes there is a nice trunk coming from the ascending aorta, sometimes not. This first branch that we can see here, coming down and around, this is the anterior interventricular branch of the LCA. The anterior interventricular branch of the LCA is sometimes also called the left anterior descending artery. And sometimes, because it is a main contributor to the interventricular septum, it might be called the widowmaker, which is a very sexist and unempathetic way to refer to a vessel. So if you hear it in the clinic, that's what they're talking about, but I might encourage you to adopt a nomenclature of greater inclusivity and empathy. The other branch is the circumflex. Circumflex because it's going to wrap around. And it will wrap around to the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. Here we can see the pulmonary trunk has been reflected down. There's the ascending aorta still. And I can see, coming from that circumflex branch around, a nice left marginal artery. So here is the anterior interventricular branch. There's the circumflex branch. And then there's the left marginal artery. The only branch named artery of all of the coronary artery branches. So the right coronary artery, here let's start with our view from above. That's going to begin in the right aortic sinus of Valsalva. Here's our right auricle, and we can see kind of a quick branching pattern here too. This is a nice robust SA nodal branch, sinoatrial nodal branch, going out to the SA node. There is our superior vena cava. There is our incised base of the heart. Pulmonary trunk still for our orientation. And here we can see that RCA heading down in the coronary sulcus. So if we take more of an anterior view here, that SA nodal artery is heading that way towards the SA node. And then the RCA dives down through the coronary sulcus, sending out a couple of branches along the way. These are feeding the right ventricle. And then one branch that I'd like us to stop and mention, the right marginal branch. Right marginal branch. That's heading out along the inferior border of the heart. Then we can see the RCA wrapping about in that coronary sulcus. It's heading this way. Here we can see the opening for the inferior vena cava. The RCA heads out across there. I can see that right marginal. There's the right marginal branch, and then heading down here to that very special region, the crux of the heart, and then we have a branching. This is the posterior interventricular branch, also known as the posterior descending artery, PDA, not public display of affection, posterior descending artery. And then the atrioventricular nodal branch, or AV nodal branch. So if we can jump over here for a second, here's that right aortic sinus. Here we go in the coronary sulcus. This is one of the reasons I absolutely love this specimen. We get to the crux approximately there, and then we can see this AV nodal branch heading on in that way. So here is our tricuspid valve. That AV nodal branch is going to be found going to the AV node, which is kind of at the nexus of the atrioventricular septum as well as the interatrial septum. So approximately right about there. So these are the coronary arteries and their branches. Thank you very much for your time.